Hello friends, welcome to my channel Cloud TV. In this video I am going to discuss about what is Hadoop. Hadoop is a Apache open source project which uses set of utilities to solve your big data problems. Basically it uses network computers to solve big data problems. So if you have a massive amount of data in terabyte and terabyte, okay, so you are not able to store it in traditional RDBMS system. So Hadoop, you can use Hadoop to store your massive amount of data. You can use Hadoop to process massive amount of data. How it is done? Let's see. So till now Hadoop has two different version of Hadoop. What is Hadoop 1.0, Hadoop 2.0. I hope recently Hadoop 3.x also released. So let's see what is Hadoop 1.0 contains, what is Hadoop 2.0 contains. In Hadoop 1.0, there are two basic level components for storage and distributed computing. For storage, the component is called HDFS, Hadoop Distributed File System, which actually uses way of storing your data in distributed manner. Another component is called MapReduce, which actually picks the data stored in HDFS and does the computation by using the network computers called cluster. In Hadoop 2.0, they introduce a new component called YARN, which actually helps to manage the cluster in better way. So in Hadoop 1.0, the disadvantage of MapReduce, the framework is, the computation framework is, it has to handle both the resource scheduling as well as the tracking the computation. Okay, and also you can actually run one type of computation, meaning or you can do only MapReduce computation here. With the introduction of YARN, it actually solves the resource management in a different process and the computation in different process. And also you can run the MapReduce job, which is batch jobs. You can run the real-time jobs using different frameworks like Spark streaming and Storm like real-time applications. And also you can run other type of jobs also on YARN. So I'll keep this video very short so that I'll give a detailed explanation with example in the coming videos. So let's see what is this Hadoop cluster contains. Basically in Spark Hadoop 1.0, in Hadoop 1.0 you have five different components to manage your Hadoop cluster. Hadoop actually works in master slave architecture. So in master node you have three different processes. One is name node, job tracker, and secondary name node. And in slave node you have data node, trust tracker. So what is the use of name node? Name node basically managing the metadata of files stored in the HDFS, right? So when you store your data into HDFS, the name node is the one which actually allocates space for you and it keeps metadata for your file. And job tracker is the one which actually manages the resource scheduling and allocates the each it probes your job into multiple tasks and allocate each task to the slave process called a task tracker. Okay, secondary name nodes keep snapshot of name node, so whenever the any name node failure happens, so you can take the backup from the secondary name node and restore it. That's how the Hadoop architecture or Hadoop cluster look like. So we'll go in detail how the SDFS stores data. So you have name node here and you have set up data nodes. So whenever clients wants to store the data into SDFS, it talks to the name node, get the block available data nodes where it can store your data. So then it says your file is broken into n number of blocks and where it has to store. So client directly takes that information and store the blocks in respective data nodes. These are the SDFS blocks and MapReduce. In MapReduce, you have three different phases of execution. One is a map phase, another is a shuffle phase, and also called shuffle and sort phase, and a reduce phase. What happens is, so whenever you want to process on top of some data in HDFS, so you submit your job to the job tracker. Job tracker will talk to the name node to get the block location of the file which you want to process. So example, you have a block 0 to block 5. Okay, so each for MapReduce world, you call the input as input split. Okay, so for each input split, you will have one mapper associated with that. So each mapper takes one input split and it processes the data. So in this case, if we have six blocks here. So example, if you have six input split, you will have six mapper running. Okay. So then what happens? So it actually, so as I said, you have three different phase. You write a code in terms of mapper and reduce. So the computation which happens on mapper writes the data, the final intermediate data into the disk of the particular node which it's running. So all this intermediate data is shuffled and sorted and sent to the respective reducers. So reducers pickups and do the aggregation stuff. So reducer mainly used for doing aggregation. So you can decide how many number of reducers you want. Then it actually take the merged intermediate data and do the aggregations and writes into output in SDFS mostly. So this is how the MapReduce works. Next, with help of map and MapReduce and SDFS and Yarn, the open source community has built many utilities or tools to process the massive data. Okay, so as I said, these two are the two main components, SDFS and MapReduce. On top of that, they built tool like OSI for managing your jobs, various jobs in Hadoop cluster, and the component called PIG, which is actually basically used to do ETL operations using scripting language called PIG. So there is a MapOut, which is a machine learning library in MapReduce build. And you have some connectors for R as well. And you have a component called Hive, which is a data warehouse tool in Hadoop. So you can actually do your SQL stuff in using Hive. So HBase is the columnar NoSQL, which is used for real-time read-write, which does you have huge writes and reads, you can use HBase. And you have another component called ZooRepair, which manages or coordinates between many components interaction. And you have Flume component, where you can use collect logs from many app server, web servers, and bring it to Hadoop to process in batch way or real time way. you have another component called Scoop, which does data import export tool from RDBMS to Hadoop system. So this is how the Hadoop component works. I'll keep this video very short. We'll see very detailed sessions in coming videos. Hello friends, share your feedbacks and comments through my YouTube channel. Thank you so much. See you in next video.